Then I ask you to look in the mirror and ask yourselves, what are you doing in this time of great challenge?
He said he would devalue it by 40%. Now, how did FDR, Franklin Delano Roosevelt, do it in 1933 and 34? You remember, he said, bring in your one-ounce gold pieces. He said, I will give you $20 for them, because stamped on that one-ounce gold piece is $20. Oh, people were patriotic. Oh, yes, we want to have back up our country. We want to help get the country out of the mess it's in. And within a few months' time, after the people turned in their one-ounce gold for a piece of paper, oh, please, people, I'm begging of you. Mr. Fromm said to me, Chaplain, if it's written on a piece of paper, it's worth the paper it's written on. They brought in their one-ounce gold pieces, and they were given a piece of paper that said you can go back to the bank and get your gold back for $20. It just said, we'll take them for $20, and they gave them a gold certificate piece of paper. Today, you don't even have that. You don't have anything but a Federal Reserve note today. It has no backing of gold or silver or anything else. And within, please hear it, within a few months, Franklin Delano Roosevelt announced one day out of a clear blue sky with no warning whatsoever, the price of gold is going up to $35 an ounce.
Yeah, so that's the type of stuff we're going to see. And we're going to have you back up in the new year to break this down more. We've got to go to calls and get their perspective, because I promised we would. But we had Gerald Celente on yesterday, and he directed us to a clip from 3 years ago of Biden and Corzine. And in the speech, he says, yeah, we had a meeting with the other bankers about a bank holiday. So they're certainly getting all of this ready. And again, a bank holiday, folks, is where they shut the banks down for a week or two. And when you come back, your dollar's been devalued in a giant step, not just incrementally. And the inflation's already out there. They're just putting out cooked numbers. But if they're talking about really devaluing it, we're talking about a hamburger being $20 instead of $5. You know, when a hamburger was $2 10 years ago, we're talking about massive wealth redistribution. We're talking about destruction of those on fixed incomes. It's just unspeakable. Let's go to phone calls here. And I guess Chris in California has been holding the longest. You're on the air with our guest. Go ahead.
Yeah. Hi, Lindsay and Alex. This is Chris. I had a question maybe either you could answer. I've been looking into this case, you probably heard of it, where there's about a month ago, there was a case filed against some of these big names like the United Nations, Ban Ki-moon, Berlusconi, and the World Economic Forum. And I think it's been largely going around the internet out of Benjamin Fulford.
Yeah, I've gotten calls about this. Have you called before, or was it somebody else?
No. I haven't called before.
Yeah, I we'll work on getting Fulford on to hear about his suit. I haven't had time to go to the lawsuit tracker and see if that's a real case. What's the name of the case?
Well, you can look it up on Pacer Case Locator. It's case number 1:2011-CV-08500.
All right, I appreciate your call. I don't know what Lindsay can say about that. I don't know if he's aware of that particular statement. But yes, China and a lot of other groups have been suing different groups in China over the fact they've been sold derivatives. You've got Bank of America and others taking houses they never had the deed to that are paid for. So I guess the globalists kind of have to have a war, Lindsay, because they've cheated not just people but countries. What does your elitist source say about that?
Well, he hasn't mentioned that at all. We've been talking so much about this currency devaluation here just recently, Alex, until I was so startled and dumbfounded and realized that everybody out there has 40% of everything that you own to be lost, until I haven't had time to do anything else but this and then do some research on what other nations did when they devalued their currency. Different things are done by different countries. And when it happens in America, exactly how is the devaluation going to take place? We don't know that. All we know is that he's going to do it. But the mere
well, they're not going to call it that. Nowadays, the mind control's gotten so intense, they'll call it an increase in the value or something. I mean, it's just untold evil. Let's talk to Nick in Illinois. Nick, you're on the air. Got a question for Lindsay?
Yeah, Alex, I had a question. What does Lindsay think of Michael Rupert? He's the investigative journalist, and he's the author of that movie, the Collapse movie, which talks about peak oil.
Yeah, peak oil is as phony as a $3 bill from research. But what's your view on peak oil, Lindsay?
Well, there is no such thing as peak oil. It's a total misnomer. When the Russians went down to drill that coal ST3 wells to 42,000 feet, they hit the mother lobe of all oil. It's not it's abiotic oil. It has nothing to do with dinosaurs and rotted plants. So now the whole textbooks have got to be written. I'm sorry, but if a person believes in peak oil, all they got to do is just find out the very latest to what's going on.
Now, there's a lot of top scientists say it's not man-made. Now, obviously, you can find some deposits that are. It does exist. You can find coal that's got, you know, dinosaur bones in it or whatever. There's obviously some of that exists. There is some fossil fuel, but it's a very small amount of it. You know, I tell you what, we'll come back and let Nick have a response back to that. Then we'll go to everybody else. Nick in Illinois, there's your answer on peak oil. You know, a lot of the globalists want to put out this idea that there's no resources so that when they cut them off and charge more for less, people will think it's a self-fulfilling prophecy. This is part of a post-industrial move that's taking place. That's why they want to shut off coal. We have enough coal to run the planet for thousands of years and do it cleanly. All they put out is carbon dioxide, so then they list carbon dioxide as a toxic waste. You have any comments to that, Nick?
I mean, I totally agree with you. I was just curious to see if you ever heard of Michael Rupert, because he has a compelling documentary back in 2009 called Collapse, and I just was curious to see if that's...
No, I know Mike. I know Mike.
Okay. Thank you.
All right, thank you so much. Let's go ahead and talk to another caller here. Let's talk to Deb in Illinois. You're on the air with our guest.
Yes, I'm calling to inquire about the shelters and the provisions that people are taking for this type of event. And I've run across one in particular, and they have indicated that Lindsay has even endorsed it. I was very curious as to what his thought was on this and if those are pretty reasonable things to do. It's a natural shelter.
I don't understand. Natural shelter. What are we talking about?
We're talking a naturally occurring shelter.
You're talking about caves, lean-tos?
Would be more in the area of a cave, yes.
Well, Lindsay, have you talked about people having caves they can run to?
Well, positively not. In fact, let me say emphatically, I have endorsed nothing. Anyone out there who says I have endorsed any organization, any shelter, any provision whatsoever, apart from what you hear me say right here on the Alex Jones Show, I did not endorse it. I do not endorse anything. I've had two big organizations ask me to be on their board within the past 2 months. I turned both of them down. I don't do that. The only thing I endorse is what the elite have told me. I know it's true. I tell it on the Alex Jones Show, and that's the only thing I endorse. I may agree with some of those, but I've never said it over radio talk shows.
Yeah, my whole issue is that this depression is going to get bad in places like New York City, places like that, bad areas of Chicago. Yeah, I've moved to the countryside. But as long as you're ready to take care of yourself, you should be okay. And if enough people wake up, that's the only thing that's made these globalists change their plans and back off. If enough people wake up, Lindsay, is it ever too late to get them to pull back?
No, you can definitely get them to pull back. And that's the reason I'm on your show today, Alex. You've got a coverage of probably 2 million listeners right now while we're talking. These people have got to know. You must know what to do. According to Ben Bernanke's speech on November the 21st, 2002, people, please, you can take precautionary action right now. And I wish we had another whole hour, Alex, so I could suggest to them, according to what my elitist friends have told me, what they should do, and they should do it immediately, and it's different than anything I've talked about in the past.
Yeah. Well, I'll tell you what, we're going to do 5 more minutes. The main show's over, but Deb, did you have any other questions or comments?
No, but I would really welcome his comments at some point in the future quickly about the what provisions exactly he thinks we should take.
Okay, well, we'll get Lindsay's take on that straight ahead. That's it for the main radio show. See you back tomorrow live, 11 a.m. to 2 p.m., but we'll come back and take a few more calls, internet only, straight ahead. Lindsay, you heard the lady's question. What would you do to get prepared? I mean, I'd say try to get good friends and neighbors and family who are living in the real world who can mutually help each other. That's most important. Have food, have water, have firearms. Be willing to use them to protect yourself. Having guns is nothing if you don't know how to use them. If you can, have some gold and silver, storable food, and water filtration. I mean, I've got a well. I got a shotgun, a rifle, and a four-wheel drive, and a country boy will survive. I think it comes down to that, Lindsay.
We need to do all of those things you just mentioned, Alex. We need to do everything that you've heard me say in the past. We need to do, you should have already done them. Everything on my new DVD series, which just came out 2012, the beginning of the end, you've got to do it. Now, let's come down to what I was given in the last few days. Mr. Bernanke said, I will, as the last, the final straw, I will devaluate the currency. Now, how much did he say he would devalue it? 30? He said he would devalue it 40%. It's there. He actually, okay, the elite, they will tell you in their buzzwords what they're going to do. Then they will do it. And then when you turn around and fuss after it's all over with, and Alex, I'm glad you're getting excited today. I feel the same way. And whenever the elite do this, and then you come back and fuss at them, and they say, well, what are you talking about? I told you.
By the way, that's what a vampire does in lore. Reading this, because I'd seen bits of this over the years, different, but reading this while you've been talking some, it is pretty wild. He sells inflation as a good thing in the first paragraph. I'm glad your elitist source, who known to myself, brought this up to you. One final little call at the end here. And we'll have to go to others tomorrow. I'm sorry. Abraham in Idaho, quick question for Lindsay Williams. You'll be our tail gunner.
Hey, Alex Lindsay. I'm a Prison Planet TV subscriber, and I just want to say God bless you guys, that my wife and I pray for you guys often.
Thank you.
And I really don't want to take too much time, but I do have like four really quick questions.
Oh, go hit them.
Kind of tie in with each other. Okay. Has your elite friend told you specifically, Lindsay, if there's going to be an attack against Syria prior to Iran, and did he give you a timeline of events leading up to an attack on Iran?
Yes, he did. And if you would like that in a three-hour DVD presentation, I produced it 9 months ago. It's entitled Middle East, the Rest of the Story. He told me every nation that would be attacked. He told me what order they'd be attacked in. He did say that Syria would come prior to Iran. He did say that Iran would be the last place to be.
And by the way, you're on record before any of this started saying this, Lindsay. What? Let's get one more of those questions quickly.
Okay, I actually want to do two more just about Russia and China.
Yeah, bro, we only got 30 seconds.
Oh, okay. Then in reference to the devil's messiah, did he say anything about how they plan to destroy the morals of America specifically?
Oh, positively. In fact, in my latest DVD presentation, 3 hours of it, 2012, the beginning of the end, I describe it in about a 30-minute detail and even show you DVDs as to how they're going to do it.
Look, Lindsay, I got the producer here right now and this caller. We obviously need to get you back on sometime this week for another hour or the first of the year. The show's over. I'll be back tonight, 7, back tomorrow, 11 a.m., Lord willing. But, Lindsay, let's set you up right now for another hour so we can answer more questions from callers. 1776!